नमस्कार विद्यार्थी मित्रांनो, वेलकम टू श्री ज्ञानसागर कोचिंग क्लासेस YouTube चॅनल। टू गेट मोर व्हिडिओ प्लीज सबस्क्राइब दिस चॅनल। स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी डिस्कस अबाउट द प्रैक्टिस 2.2 ऑफ द चैप्टर सेकंड क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन। इन दिस वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द सॉल्यूशंस ऑफ द क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन। देयर आर सम मेथड्स। फर्स्ट वन इज द फैक्टराइजेशन मेथड, सेकंड वन इज द कंप्लीटिंग स्क्वायर मेथड एंड थर्ड वन इज द फार्मूला मेथड। नाउ इन दिस फैक्टराइजेशन मेथड वी हैव टू राइट द गिवन इक्वेशन इन स्टैंडर्ड फॉर्म। Mean that ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0. Then second step is the find out the product of a and c. Third step is factorize this ac such that which having addition is middle term. Then how to solve this? Now take some examples how to solve this quadratic equation. Now practice 2.2. The first question is that solve the following quadratic equations by factorization method. Now in this first question is that x square minus 15x plus 54 is equals to 0. Student, already this given example is in standard form, ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0. Now when we comparing this, here is a is 1, b is minus 15 and c is 50 plus 54. Now how to solve? Now first, we have to find out the product of a and c, mean that 1 into 54. Means it becomes plus 54. Then find the factors of plus 54 such that which having addition is middle term, in that minus 50. Now here this is the simple numbers. Now then 9 and 6. 9, 6 are 54. Now 9 plus 6 becomes 50. Now but we have to take here minus 50. So use the sign both having minus minus. Minus minus converted as plus, so that and the addition of these two becomes minus 15. This is the correct factor of this quadratic equation. So we write this is such way that this is x square minus 15x plus 54 is equals to 0. We have to factorize as minus 9 and minus 6, so that I have to write it x square minus 9x minus 6x plus 54 is equals to 0. Make the group of two numbers here. Then whatever we take common here, here is x. In another bracket, remaining is x minus 9. Here is minus 6, here is x minus 9. Minus minus plus 6, 9 the 54 is equals to 0. Then take common bracket first, mean that x minus 9. Another bracket is x minus 6 is equals to 0. Student, we know that the property, if the product of two numbers is 0, then at least one of them must be 0. Now look carefully the property. If the product of two numbers is 0, then at least one of them must be 0. Mean that x minus 9 is equals to 0 or x minus 6 is equals to 0. Then transpose this minus to this another side. X is equals to 0 plus 9, mean that 9. Or x is equal to 0 plus 6 mean that 6. Mean that therefore this x is equal to 9 and x is equal to 6 are the solution of given quadratic equation. So I have to write here answer in full sentence. Answer therefore x is equal to 9 or x is equal to 6 are the solution of given quadratic. Can you understand first question? Then we take the second question. Now here is x square plus x minus 20 is equals to 0. Student, in this case, this is in standard form. Ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0. Here is a is 1, b is also 1 and c is minus 20. Then first we have to find out the factors of a and c, mean that 1 and minus 20, it becomes minus 20. Then factors of this minus 20 such that which having addition is plus 1. So this is also simple number 5, 4, 20. Then the sign is bigger number here, suppose that plus and here is minus. Then the product between these two is minus 20 and addition of these two is plus 1. So it is correct factor. So I have to split for the middle term. So solution, this is equation x square plus x minus 20 is equals to 0. We split these terms as x square plus plus 5x minus 4x minus 20 is equals to 0. Again, make the group of two numbers here. X in bracket, take common from here. X, x plus remaining is 5. Here is minus 4 and remaining is x plus 5 is equals to 0, because minus plus minus 4, 5 is a 20. Then take common bracket first. And the remaining values in another bracket mean that x minus 4 is equals to 0. We know that property, if the product of two numbers is 0, then at least one of them must be 0. So by using this property right here, x plus 5 is equals to 0 or x minus 4 is equals to 0. Therefore, x is equals to minus 5 or x is equals to 4 plus 4. Therefore, the answer in full sentence, answer x is equals to minus 5 or x is equals to 4 are the solutions of given quadratic equation. Can you understand this? Okay, then take the next question. Let's see the question number third. 2y square plus 27y plus 13 is equals to 0. Student, already the given equation is standard form. So, a is 2, b is 27, and c is 13. Now I have to write the product of a and c here. Now its solution. A is 2 and c is 13. 13 2's are 26. I mean plus sign. Find out the factors of this 26 such that which having addition is the middle term. Mean that here is we take 26 such that 26 into 1, 26 1 is 26, both having sign is plus, then the product is 26 1 is 26, 26 plus 1 becomes 27. So split the middle term such that which having addition is 27. We write here again. Therefore, 2y square plus 27y plus 13 is equals to 0. Then split the middle term. 2y square plus 26y plus 1y plus 13 is equals to 0. Then take common out of these two. Here is 2y take common in bracket. Y plus 13 plus here is 1 take common. In bracket y plus 13 is equals to 0. Then take common bracket first, mean that y plus 13. Then remaining brackets is 2y plus 1 is equals to 0. We know that the property, if the product of two terms is 0, then at least one of them must be 0. Therefore, this y plus 13 is equals to 0 or 2y plus 1 is equals to 0. Then these 13 and 1 transposed to this another side. Therefore, y is equals to minus 30 or 2y is equals to how much? Minus 1. Therefore, y is equals to minus 1 upon 2. Then we write the answer in full sentence. Therefore, answer. Here is minus 13 and minus 1 upon 2 are the roots of given quadratic equation, or that is the solution of that given equation. Can you understand this? We see the next question. The next question is 5m square is equal to 22m plus 50. Student, first we write this in a standard form, then transpose this term to this another side, so its solution is, this is 5m square minus 22m minus 15 is equals to 0. Can you understand this transposition? Plus the notator minus, plus the notator minus. Then find out the product of a and c. 15 5 is minus 75. Then find out the factors of minus 75 which having addition is the middle term, in that minus 1. So the factors is also simple here. 25 3 is a. Give the proper sign. Now if take here minus and this is the plus, then the product is minus 75 and its addition is minus 22. So split this value for the middle term. So therefore 5m square minus 25m plus 3m minus 15 is equal to 0. Then make the group of two numbers. Then taking common here is we take common 5 and m also. So remaining bracket is that m minus 5m into m is 5m square. 5 5s are 25 into m minus 25. Then here is plus 3 take common here in bracket m minus 5. Plus 3m plus minus 3 5 is 50 is equals to 0. Then take common bracket first, m minus 5. Another one is that 5m plus 3 is equals to how much? 0. Then m minus 5 is equals to 0 or 5m plus 3 is equals to 0. Transpose to this another side, m is equals to 0 plus 5, mean that 5, or 5m is equals to minus 3. Then m is equals to minus 3 upon how much? 5. We cannot simplify here, so that this is the value of m. Therefore the answer in full sentence, answer here is m is equal to 5 and minus 3 upon 5 are the solution of given quadratic equation. We write here 5 comma minus 3 upon 5 are the solutions of given quadratic equation. Can you understand this? Then we see the next question. Here is the next question is twice x square minus twice x plus 1 upon 2 is equals to 0. Student, here observe carefully, denominator is 2. I have to remove this denominator. For removing this, multiply both sides of the equation by 2. Here I have to write in solution. Multiplying both sides of equation by 2, we get, I have to directly write this equation. Then when we multiply it, it becomes 4x square minus 4x plus 1 is equals to 0. It is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0. A is 4, b is minus 4 and c is 1. Then find out the product of AC, mean that 4 into 1 is 4 plus 4. Then split this plus 4 for middle term such that find out the factors of this 4 which have in addition is minus 4. Now for this we take here suppose 2 2's are 4, both having minus sign, minus minus it becomes plus and addition becomes minus 4. So we write for the middle term. This one is 4x square minus 2x minus 2x plus 1 is equals to 0. Again, take the group of two numbers here. Then here is we take common 2x in bracket. 2x minus 1. Here is also we take common minus 1 in bracket. 2x, here is minus 7. Because minus minus plus 1 is equals to 0. Then take common bracket first, twice x minus 1. Remaining values in another bracket is equals to how much? 0. We know that if the product of two terms is 0, then at least one of them must be 0. So that this term is also 0 or this term is also 0. Then transpose this to this another side, we get that twice x is equals to 1, or here is also twice x is equals to 1, mean that x is equals to 1 upon 2 or x is equals to also 1 upon 2, means therefore this is the same value. So write the answer. So answer is such that 1 upon 2 is the solution of given quadratic. Can you understand this? We see the next question. Let's see the question number 6. if you have to multiply this x to the both side, now we remove this x. So multiplying x by both sides we get. Now when we multiply it, we get here 6x square minus this xx get cancelled in that only 2 is equals to into 1 into x means 1x. Transfer this to this another side, which is the standard form of the quadratic equation, is equals to 0. Then find out the product of a and c. A and c is minus 12. Then the factorize this minus 12 such as which have addition is minus 1. Mean that 4 3s are or 3 4s are. Here is having minus sign, here is plus sign. Minus 4 plus 3. Then split for middle term. So we write here 6x square minus 4x plus 3x minus 2 is equals to 0. When we take its addition, we get minus 1x. Then take two groups here. Take common here. Here is 2x, take common. Here is remaining is 3x minus 2. Here is plus 1 in bracket. We take here 3x minus 2 is equals to 0. When you multiply this 1, there is no change in the signs. Then take common bracket first, mean that 3x minus 2. Remaining value is in another bracket, mean that twice x plus 1 is equals to how much? 0. Then we know that the property of the product of two terms is 0. Then at least one of them must be 0. Means 3x minus 2 is equals to 0 or 2x plus 1 is equals to how much? 0. Then transpose this minus 2 and plus 1 to this side, we get 3x is equals to 2 or 2x is equals to minus 1. Then transpose this 3 to this another side, we get that x is equals to 2 upon 3. X is equals to minus 1 upon 2. Therefore, answer in full sentence. 2 upon 3 minus 1 upon 2 are the solution or roots of given quadratic equation. Can you understand this? Okay, let's see the next question. Next question, question is activity based question. Question number 7. Complete the following activity to solve the quadratic equation root of 2x square plus 7x plus 5 root 2 is equal to 0 by factorization method. Now student, this is in standard form ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Student, first we have to find out the product of a and c. Root 2 into 5 root 2. Student, root 2 into 5 root 2 becomes 5. Root 2 into root 2 is 2. 5 2s are how much? 10. Then find the factors of this 10 which have addition is middle term. Mean that we have to split for this middle term. Then this is also simple. 5 2s are 10. 5 plus 2 becomes 7. So we have to split for the middle terms. Mean that in our first box here is 5x and in another second box is 2x. Then look carefully. Here is x square. Here is x. We take common x here. Then remaining is root of 2x plus 5. Then another bracket. Here is root 2 take common here. Mean that 1 root 2 is present here. Mean that root into x. Here is root 2 take common, so remaining is 5. Student, then here take common bracket first. Mean that here we write root of 2x plus 5. In another bracket the remaining values x plus root 2. Then we know that the property, if the product of two term is 0, then at least one of them must be 0. So this value becomes 0 and this value also becomes 0. So I have to write here root of x plus 5 is equals to 0 or x plus root of 2 is equals to 0. Then this value is equal to 0, transpose this 5 to this another side, convert as minus 5, and this root 2 is goes to denominator. So directly take here, this value is minus 5 upon root of 2. And here is direct right there answer, x is equals to minus root of 2. Then here is x is equals to minus 5 upon root 2, and root of minus 2 are the roots of the given equation. This is the solution of this activity. Can you understand? We see the next question. Question number 8 is 3x square minus 2 root of 6x plus 2 is equals to 0. This is also in standard form of the quadratic equation. Find out the product of A and C. A is 3 and C is 2. Mean that 3 into 2 is equals to how much? 6. Find out the factors of 6. Whichever addition is middle term. Mean that minus 2 root of 6. Here is only 6 here. Now so I have to factorize this as root of 6 into root of 6. Mean that it becomes 6. If both having minus minus sign, then minus minus plus. And the addition become these two is minus 2 root of 6. So it is correct factor. So write down the solution. The equation is 3x square minus 2 root of 6x plus 2 is equals to 0. Split for the middle term. Mean that 3x square minus root of 6x minus root of 6x plus 2 is equals to 0. This addition becomes minus 2 root of 6x. Then take common here. Here is, look carefully, here we take common root of 3x in bracket. Here is also root of 3x minus, we take common here, root of 2. Student, when we multiply this, we get that this value, look carefully, root 3 into root 3 is 3 into x square. Then root 3 into root 2 is root 6 into x. Then here also we take common. Here is minus root 2 take common. If you take minus root 2, then here is root 3 into x. Root 3 into root 2 is root 6 into x. Then here is minus root 2, because minus minus plus, root 2 into root 2 is plus 2. This is the factors, is equals to 0. Then we write the common bracket first, mean that root 3x minus root 2. Another value is in another bracket, mean that root 3x minus root 2 is equals to 0. Means, all of you know that term, if product of two term is 0, then at least one of them must be 0. Mean that root 3x minus root 2 is equals to 0, or root 3x minus root 2 is equals to also 0. Then transpose it to this another side. Root 3x is equals to root of 2, or root 3x is equals to root of 2. Then transpose this again, we get that root 2 upon root 3, or root a, here is x is equals to root 2 upon root 3. Means we write this x is equals to in one root radical sign root 3, root 2 upon 3, or x is equals to in one radical sign 2 upon 3. Now this is the same value. You have to write 2 root 2 upon 3 and root 2 upon 3, or simply you have to write root 2 upon 3 is the solution of given equation. Answer in full sentence. Here is root 2 upon 3 and root 2 upon 3 are the roots of given quadratic equation. Can you understand this? So important example. Okay, the next question is that, question number 9. Twice m in bracket m minus 24 is equal to 50. The solution of such type of the equation is, Student, we have to multiply this toys m to this whole bracket. We get that. This is toys m square minus 2 into 24 is 48 m is equals to 50. Then transpose this 50 to this another side. This equation becomes 2m square minus 48m minus 50 is equals to 0. Again we can reduce this, dividing both sides by 2.
So I have to write the next thing is 7m in bracket. Here is m.
minus 3 is equals to how much? 0. Now student, this is one bracket and this is second bracket. Mean that the product of two terms is 0. Mean that at least one of them must be 0. Means we write here, therefore 7m is equals to 0 or m minus 3 is equals to 0. Then this 7 goes to denominator. Mean that 0 upon 7 or m is equals to how much? 3. We can simplify it. Mean that m is equals to, you have to divide this 7, we get the answer is 0. Or m is equals to how much? 3. Therefore the answer in full sentence, 0 and 3 are the roots of given quadratic equation. Can you understand this? Okay. Then our last example of the practice set 2.2, question number 12. M square minus 11 is equals to 0. Now this is also a quadratic equation. We write this such as m square minus 11 is equals to 0. This is one identity. We write here m square minus, this is root of 11 bracket square is equals to 0. Means again we use here a square minus b square property. This identity is that a plus b, another bracket a minus b is equals to 0. So we write here m plus root of 11, another bracket m minus root of 11 is equals to 0. Here is, use the property, a square minus b square is equals to a plus b, a minus b. Then we know that if the product of two terms is 0, then at least one of them must be 0. Therefore m plus root of 11 is equals to 0 or m minus root of 11 is equals to 0. Then the answer is this plus transpose to this another side, m is equals to minus root of 11 or m is equals to root of 11. So that the answer in full sentence, answer minus root of 11 and root of 11 are the roots of given quadratic equation. Can you understand this?